takes just a minute to
all good.
Arise.
This is not showing on Facebook yet, right?
Not yet. No, I'm actually
look at my nails. In. Like, seriously, look at COVID-19 nail. Like, I'm going to try to keep my hands down.
Luckily, if you're moving, I have to look really close to notice.
Okay.
So
I'm just like,
okay, now we can go live.
All right.
Ready? Here we go. Hey everyone, thank you for joining us live here today. I am with the amazing Melanie Klein. Melanie is a women's advocate, consciousness raiser, empowerment mentor, a pioneer in the yogi space, an author, an educator, a mother, and a truth teller. All of those things wrapped into one. Thank you so much for being here today, Melanie.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yes, absolutely. I'm so excited to reveal your brand and discuss the process and share everyone your new logos and the direction that you're heading in. So I'd love for you, I mean, I gave you all of the titles, but if you could tell us and the audience just a little bit more about your background, kind of your belief system, and why you really wanted to step into the branding process now on your journey.
Yeah, great questions. For me, I come from both an academic background as a professor in higher education, as well as a social advocacy background that goes back 26 years, where once I went out of my teen years, I transformed my angst into activism and was really on the ground, you know, when we had those grassroots movements long before the internet, for really creating sustainable, you know, social change for all marginalized groups. And that paired very nicely with my discovery of yoga and meditation, which was a couple years later. So that was 1996. And I very quickly found that both of those things really, you know, were complements to one another and essentially, you know, two parts of the same thing, which is, you know, how can we raise our consciousness in order to serve in the world more fully, to step into ourselves more fully, so that we can really be those change makers that we so desperately need. And so that really was the crux of my work starting then, that I wanted to kind of pair those two things that very much were separate at the time. Mm-hmm. You know, folks in my academic and even social advocacy work didn't quite understand the role of yoga and meditation, which they're fairly mainstream, I would say, you know, household words at this time, but certainly in the 1990s, it was very difficult to find studios. It was definitely something that was very fringe at the time. And so I couldn't quite understand how that meshed. And then there was also, I found a real resistance in the yoga, wellness, and spiritual community, if you will, around having really critical conversations around privilege and oppression. And so for me, the change that I wanted to see in the world and the change that I wanted to create in the world, they couldn't happen without each other. And so I brought that into the classroom. I brought that into my coaching work. I brought that into the writing that I've done. And it's really, you know, I usually like to sum it up. It's individual transformation for collective liberation. And the last part of your question, why step in the branding process? I think anybody who listened to your introduction can see there's a lot of moving parts in my world. And there is a central axis, which has been around consciousness raising and taking action from that place. And yet, you know, there's so many, you know, kind of spokes coming from that, from the writing to the speaking to, you know, doing the advocacy, you know, the media, you know, criticism that I've done, to clients, to teaching. It's like, how do I bring that all together, as well as, you know, then academia, social justice, and mindfulness, and have it make sense to a person who hasn't been following my work for the last 20 years? Like, how do I communicate that in a way that's really effective? Not to mention, I'll be quite honest, I've been so, you know, deep in this work for so long, it's sometimes very difficult for me to step outside of it and actually see it from an objective lens, where, you know, there were times in the process where you're asking how to pare it down. I'm like, I don't actually know what I do. I mean, I do, but if you want me to put it in one word, create a tagline, I'm like, I don't think I can do that. And so for me to continue to share my work and create opportunities for people to have access to that, I knew it was time to have someone help me streamline, you know what I mean? And kind of, you know, help me kind of manage all of that content.
Yeah. And it was a fun challenge. I love a good challenge. And you are definitely like the epitome of multi-passionate. And yeah, you just have such an amazing body of work. So it was definitely an honor to have that challenge. And, you know, my famous saying is you can't see a label from inside the bottle. And so that's really where, you know, I can show up to be a mirror and to reflect back to you, you know, all of those things. So it was a very fun and interesting process for sure. Yes. And, you know, in the brand reveal yesterday, Nina even said she had moments where she was like, what is even going to happen? Like, I feel like we're not even doing this process. So it's really fun to reveal to you and everybody live on Facebook how we have brought. So you have seen the brand story and the brand manual, which we're going to walk through briefly, just so people can get a sense of how do you tie all those things in together. And then also reveal the logos, which you've seen little bits of, but not really. So I'm really excited about that. So to start out, let's jump into the, just going to move some things around here.
And I have to say, while you're pulling that up, to kind of echo what Nina was saying in her reveal yesterday, I mean, one thing that I loved was that I could tell you at different points, like, I don't know what the hell is going on. I'm super confused. And of course, with the COVID-19 thing happening, I was like, I'm super taxed. My brain's not working. And I have to say, for someone who manages so much and handles so much for so many people, including my family and my larger community, clients, students, what a relief it was for me to have a space where I could just be held. Like it's not many places that I have that or even am able to trust that process. And I felt very like, okay, I can just kind of like, you know, I can sit in the back seat and nap a little bit, wake back up. And that was really nice. So yeah, I can relate to Nina and just wanted to add that's a super special experience to be able to have for people who are really, you know, in leadership roles to be able to like step back from that.
Yeah. Thank you for mentioning that. I've never heard anybody say it like that, but it is a big thing. Like you're saying, when you're so responsible as a leader to hold space, and I really love holding spaces for people who, same as you, for people who are making a big difference in the world. I think it's just so important.
It is.
Especially right now too, with everything. I'm just sharing my screen. You know, like you mentioned, we're in a different time right now. And I feel like the work that I'm doing helps the people like you who are in there trying to make systemic changes and really make a difference. And it's so important to just push the work out more now than ever.
Yes, I agreed. And we have to know when we lean in, when we lean out, when we lead, and when we can be led and we can kind of relax. It's essential that we really preserve our internal and external resources at this time and use them effectively.
So good. Can you see my screen okay?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Just wanted to make sure before I go in.
I feel like you're opening the door to my house and
people can see all your secrets.
Yes.
We'll just get past some of the good stuff. But
okay.
We will just dive right in. And people can, I think it is really important to stop here. And this is what I've been doing on all the brand reveals. So those of you who are joining us live, thank you, by the way. I get on a tangent and just start talking because I get so excited to reveal the stuff. So thank you for being here. If you're on the replay, please say hello, ask us questions.
Definitely.
And then we'll just dive right in. I think it's so important for people to hear again, and I keep saying the same things over and over again, is how important the brand foundational pieces are before we can add on the visual manifestation of the aesthetics, right? Because if you don't have these pieces clear, which is what I find when people come to me, they've had logos and they've had websites, but they've never just really fully stepped into it or felt 100% comfortable with it. And typically it's because they haven't done all of this work. So just speaking about the values and your vision, mission, and big idea, I would love to hear from you how it felt to get clarity on those and to really, like you said, you do so many things and you're so multidimensional to really pinpoint it into kind of two pages.
Yes. And I definitely was resistant, like, oh, like which one things do I pick and what do I pare away? And yet it was very helpful. I think what became really clear, again, was, you know, I've done a lot of work in terms of body positive spaces, which also coincides with media literacy and representation, a lot around, you know, how can we, you know, really access the authentic nature of our voice, and more importantly, mm-hmm. once we do, be able to proclaim it and have it contribute to the collective. And so all of these things, you know, where it's like over here and over here, and then, you know, the mindfulness stuff and the embodiment work, really in clarifying the vision and the values was like, this is truly about people being able to live fully and consciously, contribute in meaningful ways, to be informed in order to take, you know, intentional actions, mm-hmm. make very intentional decisions in their lives that is beyond simply what's happening in their own immediate world. Meaning like, how does my life, how do my decisions, how does my ability to show up fully, how does my ability to be at peace with myself actually contribute? How does that ripple out? You know, coming from a sociological background as well, for me, it's so important for individuals to understand, you know, self-care, wellness, empowerment, those are all really important things, body positivity. And in many ways, I would say that they're, you know, they're kind of, they're buzzwords at this point, you know, people use them a lot. And I think one of the things that's important for me is to not lose sight of the depth of all of that and say, okay, those things are really wonderful, but they really don't have maximum potency. They're not fully efficient if we're not centering ourselves right within the collective, and to understand that the decisions we make, the things that we purchase, the things that we say, the kind of relationships that we have, we're essentially role modeling, and we're in our daily life contributing to this culture that we're living in. And so it's about, let's go ahead and take care of what's here, but let's not lose sight of the fact that we're in relationships and systems with others, and that we have a much greater impact than we can even really see, that we're more powerful than we usually give ourselves credit for. And with that power, there is also responsibility that comes mm-hmm. in the form of being conscious and mindful of how we use that and how it impacts others.
Oh my gosh, yes. And I think one of them too is, you know, one of the big ideas was, when we step fully into our power and show up fully, we become an agent of change to help raise the consciousness on the global scale. And I especially love that piece of it, because it truly does embody everything that you're saying from all the different angles. And it's, you know, one thing that really stood out to me too is there's life coaching, and that's important. A lot of people need help and handholding through general life. But for you, it's so much deeper, because, you know, it's about the gender equality, conscious choices, all of those things. So I really, really loved helping pare that down a little bit.
And I have to say, I get really pumped. So I'm going to say one more thing. So you stop me when you need to, because I get really jazzed.
No, it's so good. And that's part of these, why I'm also doing these brand reveals, obviously to show my process and how I work, but it really is to shine a light on the amazing people that come into my cohorts, because you ladies were all just so amazing collectively, but individually. Yeah. And your work specifically, everybody work is so important, but this work specifically is, it just feels so timely to what we're going through as a collective right now.
Yeah, it is. And I loved, you know, not only working with you, and I think people even watching can see how, with all my stuff, how you were able to rein me in, like corral it a little bit, but also being part of a cohort is really powerful, because for me, you know, it's about the work that we're doing, but also how we commune and we're in relationship with others, how we have camaraderie, we have a sense of solidarity. We understand that by one person being empowered, that doesn't mean that we're taking away from someone else. And especially, I think, for girls and women, that's such a crucial point, because we oftentimes grow up with this scarcity mentality around, well, if she has that, I can't. If she, has that opportunity, that means I can't. And that we, you know, that mean girl culture that was created, where I can't tell you how many times I've heard women say, and I said it in my younger life, all my friends are guys, that somehow.
That was 100% me. If anybody, all my old Facebook friends.
Yeah. And it really took me until I started raising my consciousness and was starting to, you know, study feminist theory and sociology and all of these things, that I was able to unravel, you know, all the parts of myself that had been imposed on me from the outside, and to consider, my goodness, if that's how I feel about other women, like, what does that really say about my own identity? Mm-hmm. And as I became more empowered because of my own mentors and this community that I was a part of, it really, I was compelled. It was very clear to me, and again, this is about 1994, that this was, I didn't have a choice in this operation. Like, I was devoted to giving people access to the tools, the skills, the information, the practices that could also allow them to move into their own authentic, empowered self, which is going to be different than what it looks like for me, what it looks like that's different for you. And so that absolutely. I, selfishly, I will say, part of it has been the more empowered you are, the more empowered each woman in our cohort is, more empowered the individuals listening become, this means it raises the collective frequency for everyone. Mm. It means that the skill sets, the gifts, the points of mastery that may be hidden, may not be realized, may not have be discovered within a person, when we're able to find that, we are able to contribute that. And we all benefit. We have a whole pool of resources that we're not accessing when we are limiting people's ability to live their fullest versions of themselves. And that's really what I want to do, is like, let's have access to all of these resources. And I think people are discovering right now with COVID, like, yeah, what really does work for me and what's different for that family? And let's not compare to this, like, really, in many ways, being uncomfortable with the fact that they're not able to fill their time and their space with the usual distractions, and like, okay, I really get to face myself and discover, right? Like, what do I want to contribute? Who do I want to be at the end of this? What do I want to take with me from this time to build, you know, a different vision of society? So, in essence, I've been doing that for years, because I think it's crucial that we need that. We need everyone to be in their zone of genius and to develop their area of mastery and contribute. I think it's a beautiful, it's a beautiful thing. And I do not say that, you know, on a surface level. I mean that very deeply. Like, it's a powerful thing to do.
It really is. And I think a lot of people too are, you know, getting back more into their purpose, right? And polishing that and really playing with it. So I think it all really ties together. And thank you for bringing that up too with the cohort, because I've had a lot of people and, oh, I don't want to join another group program. And I think you said it well, it's more of that support system to be going through the journey with other people. It's not like you have to show up all the time. It's very easy. And it's also like a mini, mastermind / get your bounce your ideas off the wall together. It's always hard for me to explain that, so thank you for bringing that up as well. So just to go through the last little piece of the brand foundation here, like I said, it's really important to get this piece clear before you can do the visual manifestation. So your brand story, this is really the message, which I said the other day, it's kind of my secret sauce, and a lot of brand experts go through that process with people. So I won't share. Plus, it's just a lot of verbiage.
It is.
And it's really great because now you can take that specifically and apply it to the website, which we'll be working on next, and apply it to landing pages and, you know, when you're featured in the media and things like that. So, but I do want to end at this last page, which again, it's to summarize everything you do, and then it'll also be reflective in the visual manifestation, which we'll go to right next, is really what it boiled down to. And these are just some of the terminologies that you used before. So part of the process was simply kind of grasping and being like, okay, this is it. And this is really kind of what stood out as the end, was claim your truth, fulfill your potential. And then finally at the end, ignite your inner revolution, because that's really what you're helping women do, is step into their power and really empower them, to, you know, step into their power.
Yeah. And just if people can't see it with the ignite your inner revolution, right? The R is in parentheses. So it's like the R evolution. I actually, many years ago with one of my classes, we created a zine that where we use that as well. I knew that was going to be part of my personal work as well, because I feel that really speaks to this idea that we can have sort of a revolutionary shift across the board as a culture, but that also requires us to do the inner work. And if we go back to a lot of the social movements, you know, in the 1950s and 60s, you know, a really foundational piece, obviously in civil rights and, you know, Black liberation was speaking truth to power. We're looking at the second wave of feminism. It was consciousness raising groups going, you know, we have to do this inner work. And there was a critique to a certain degree of like, oh, is this just empty navel gazing if you're having these conversations? And it's like, no, actually, it's really essential. If we're going to go out there as an agent of change, we have to deal with our own internalized oppression. What are the ways that we've taken those, you know, scripts from the dominant culture and come to believe those things about ourselves? And then in effect, while we're, yes, dealing with structural obstacles and challenges, we're also limiting ourselves from the inside out, not just from the outside in. And so I felt like that really spoke to the fact we have to be doing both consistently and, you know, simultaneously.
Yeah. That's amazing. And it makes me think of too, like the term unconsciously competent, like how many people, even if they're out there and they're doing the work, are they really consciously doing it? A lot of times people get far enough in life, right, unconsciously. And even if it's not an everyday struggle. So I think that's, yeah, just so well said.
Thank you.
Okay. So let's go ahead and share again. So now we'll jump into, the always what I say is the fun part, the actual review.
And the hard part to pick people.
Yes, I don't really talk about that much, but I do provide a lot of variations and options.
And it's great. So. Yeah, it's great.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, I mean, there were so many, I was like, oh, that one. And yeah, really to sit with it and to think about, you know, all the different parts of the story. So I loved how you did that. And how under each logo you offered an explanation to what part of the brand it spoke to. And as a person with an artistic background myself, I loved kind of, you know, the symbolism and things that you layered in that. That was really helpful for me to think about.
Awesome. Thank you for that. Someday I'll have to share that with people too. It's kind of my behind the scenes magic.
Ooh, fun. So I love this.
This is the end representation. So when we talked about, again, everything that we've just been talking about, so confidence, consciousness, and that empowerment piece, then we have the prosperity, pleasure, and power, which we haven't really talked about yet, but you talk about those three things a lot and how important that is as women that we step into those. The awakening, awareness, and the authenticity. And then again, once in that empowerment piece, you help people really become visible, really get close to their truth, live into their potential. And then in the end, it's really about that evolution or revolution, if we add the R.
So I love the way this looks. It's amazing.
All of those together, and then we melded that, and this is your final logo. Like you said, you probably, I can't remember exactly how many variations you had. I think it was at least 12 13. To 15, 13. Okay. You remember lucky number 13. I do so many for everybody. I'm like, I don't even remember anymore.
Yeah.
But this one, and as you said, I always provide an explanation for every concept, but also every final logo. So this one really has that high end look that speaks to the credibility and the depth of work that you've accomplished, but it also is really unique and bold. And it is really simple because the simplicity will allow the logo to transfer across all of your marketing platforms, but also for your personality and your edginess. You know, you have that streetwise edginess too that we haven't really talked about.
Right.
So that can come out in your photographs and that can come out in other ways in your brand. But this really stands apart as, you know, just a very simple, clean look for your personal brand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love it. Mm. And I love how that pairs with that last slide. Super exciting to actually see the visual, and you know, people who are watching don't know. I mean, I've never seen this before, and it's like, oh, this is kind of like that moment of like, oh, I see how it all came together. Wow, like that. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. I love that. Thank you.
Absolutely. That's why I love to do these lives, because it's so fun for me. It's a little nerve wracking sometimes. So I'm like, what if somebody hates it? But so far, nobody's ever had that problem. So.
Ooh, fun. So oh, I love it.
The sub logos. So one thing that you and I, Melanie, uncovered during our time together is you were talking about having a Facebook group. Mm-hmm. And not that Facebook groups are a bad thing by any means, but even having one myself, I just feel like this past year there's been a lot of less engagement in Facebook groups and people are just busy and not spending a lot of time. And so we really talked about you kind of heading over to YouTube and creating sort of like a mini series, a show where you can really empower women. So I'll let you speak to that, but that's what this first logo is about. And then the second set of logos, you know, when we talk about ignite your inner revolution, and that really creates a spark. We played with ignition, like, you know, flames and things like that, but it felt a little cheesy and overdone, like
corny.
Corny. Yeah. So the concept I came up with that is actually a spark. So there's different variations of a spark that then will lend into your different levels of working with people.
Yeah, I dig it. And I mean, just Tiffany is that was so helpful in terms of even, you know, boxing back and forth to kind of come up with what is the name. And, you know, it's just, I think it's important for people to know that this is not just a group program, that, you know, we have one-on-ones with you in between, you know, group calls, and that we have that access that's so powerful and important to kind of, you know, lend a little more distance to what we're thinking about. And in this case, going back with what are some of the key phrases, you know, what are we going to bring in? And I love this because in terms of rewriting the story, that brings in the piece of all the books that I published and my penchant for collecting stories. I mean, right now I even started a writing group during this period just in service so people can process. And it's like, how can we process what's happening now and kind of reimagine and rewrite our future? So I love how, without being so obvious about it, it really pulls in that piece about my love for personal narrative as a powerful way to engage people to reach their hearts and allow them to be inspired to think differently without it coming from a really kind of rote academic place. So that's really exciting for me. Love that.
Awesome. I'm so glad you like it. And yeah, like you said, Voxer is like my best friend, although like lots of times I'll wake up to 30 Voxers from people, but it really does allow you to just talk ideas out and to talk it back and forth and to have that space. And I tell people, Vox me at 3 a.m. My phone is off, but literally people, I know how it is. Like, I have note cards all over my house with ideas I get. And so it's like, just send me a message. So we literally kind of finalized this piece over the last couple of days because it just hadn't really come. And I really love where it ended up with the rewrite the story. And you're really going to discuss with underrepresented people. And you could probably speak to that better than I could, but you know, the media representation piece about like all these women that are underrepresented, and they're really revolutionary women that stories need to be told. So I just love that you're doing this.
Yeah. I mean, that's another component in terms of, you know, for me during this, this time, I've been thinking so much about stories my grandparents told me, you know, living through the war, you know, just the oral history that was a big part of the way that I grew up and why I felt so strongly about putting the kinds of books together that I have over the years. And at the same time, talking about the fact that we, you know, really we're either underrepresented or we're misrepresented in terms of whose stories are turned into movies or where there's documentaries or who's interviewed, who's in the cover of a magazine. And for me, it's about really diversifying the kind of role models that we create, not only for other girls and women, but also for everyone in society. You know, what would it be if we actually knew the contributions that have been made historically and, you know, the unique issues and contributions being made by everyday women and girls today, and those everyday women and girls who are actually extraordinary, what would that do for the level of respect, regard? What would that do to rates of domestic violence? What would that do to, you know, the levels of objectification if girls and women were actually seen as full human beings and there was the sense of, you know, equality that was occurring? So it's really been a mission for me to make sure that those everyday stories and their power and their extraordinary nature are shared, because that's also a lost part of our heritage when we don't know those stories and we don't know those contributions.
Yeah, it's so true. And as Americans, you know, we are such a melting pot. And like you said, women, children, and all ethnicities, like it's just so important. So I'm just honored to be a part of that.
I'm so glad that you helped me put this all together. I could not be more grateful.
Yay. So just to finalize the brand piece, and then we can close up. These are the final colors. So really, the colors, the two kind of primary colors, three colors really, that are similar to what you've already have. So what I've said before is a lot of people who come and work with me already have a brand, and they've never really felt at home with it, but there's always pieces that they love. You know, there's certain messaging mm-hmm. pieces that they love. And one thing that you did love was kind of the two colors that you've already had, which was the golden color, the gray and the black. So we kept those just so that would stay, you know, a correlating thread throughout everything, but then also added in like a turquoise color and this indigo, which love. I felt the indigo is really strong. It's very popular in the yoga community for various reasons. It also brings in that femininity without being too feminine. And then mm-hmm. the turquoise too, just because you mentioned you like turquoise.
Mm-hmm. A lot of yeah. Yes. Uh-huh.
And then the fonts. And then last but not least is the visual presence.
It.
So
ooh,
everybody who's watching, the next step when working with me is we're going to be working on Melanie's and a lot of the ladies in the group's websites. I also creative direct the photo shoot. So yep. we're putting this together at a really high level visual presence standpoint. Of course, the photo shoot will happen when we're able to go outside again.
Yes.
But, when it's safe. But this really encapsulates, you know, there's a picture of you that's already taken that's beautiful, and you can bring in some of those legacy pieces of the brand, yeah. but then also add, you know, pops of color. And really what I love about you is that you have this like academic piece, but these street starts piece. So what is that like, very edgy, but also kind of glam and high end? Like, how do we mesh those together? And that's
right.
with only six spaces for pictures, that's kind of what the representation we have here that will carry into the photo shoot and the website.
Love it. Yes.
Awesome. So that is pretty much a wrap.
That
went
fast. As far as
sharing everything. I know it goes fast, but obviously we still have some work to do. So we'll have for everybody joining over the weekend and towards the beginning of next week, I'll actually be sharing a few brand reveals for women that were, and I work with men too. It just happens to be women.
Right.
A few people that have been in my previous cohorts that we have now finished their websites. So I'm going to be showing what it looks like to actually the people like Melanie, the women we've just finished the brand piece. Now, what does that look like translated into an entire website with a fully finished brand, which is the next steps we'll do. So every day for 3 or 4 more days, you can still come here and watch another brand reveal. And Melanie, thank you again for being with me today. It was such a pleasure and an honor. And where can people, obviously, on your website, where else would you say is best to follow you? And then on an upcoming YouTube channel as well.
I'm going to say, so melanieckline.com. Definitely you can connect with me on my website. In terms of social media, Instagram, Mel Klein is the best place to catch me, DM me. If you're interested in any information in terms of content, there's plenty of books that I've published that are great starting points to kind of begin the journey. So would definitely recommend that as well for people who want to dive in.
Yes. Awesome. Yes. Melanie is a powerhouse. She has so much content out there. You can see her media page. It's just like filled up. So you can read so much of what she's written. And for those of you that are interested in a brand reveal like this at some point, if it's something that you've been looking forward to, especially with everything going on and you just haven't felt quite at home in your brands, I will be starting a new cohort in April. So you could DM me and we could talk through that. I'm also starting a beta group for what I'm calling the brand foundations group for people that aren't really ready to step in fully to the entire brand piece. We can get really clear on your messaging. So if you're interested in that, absolutely contact me. And we will wrap for today. So Melanie, thank you again so much.
Thank you. And everybody, I highly recommend working with Tiffany. This is my last 2 cents. It really has been a pretty fun and magical process. So definitely, you know, check in with that. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Bye, everybody. See you tomorrow.